one of the things I like about my car, it's low, easy, you know. I don't need my keys to open it, I just need to be close to it, so my keys can be in my pocket, and I just grab this with my hands and it's open. I just close it and just with my thumbprint.
One of the factors I really like about Europe is you're free, you know, you can walk easily and you don't need to, like, you don't get too much attentions and things like that. You have peace, and you know, that's one thing I like, because I like to be really simple and just go out and come in without nobody disturbing me. So yeah, I like Lagos, and I, of course, when I'm in Lagos, I like this feeling, you know, because I come from the hood, and when I go back, I always pay respect to the hood. I like to see these guys, you know, they make my time there really fun. So yeah, in Lagos, I like this, you know, I miss them, first back. But I'm not, well, I played in Festac, and I moved to Europe from Festac, so I'm being tagged a Festac boy, but I was born in Ojo Barracks, so I'm also a Barracks boy, and I lived in Okoko for a long time. So, you know, three of these hood, I respect a lot. They are my hood, and I love it when I'm there. I got Irish pop close to me. It's really, I like it, because there's always a lot of noise, a lot of foreigners, a lot of English people coming here, you know, to watch the games. And also, I like them because they're kind of really lively. No, a little bit loud, but okay. I love the noise a little. Alright, it's time for lunch with Omar. And, okay.
So, what do we have for lunch? What does this look like? Okay. Explain to us.
So, you got your pasta. And you got piselli e tonno. And this is ragu. It's a sauce. Italian sauce. It's really nice. And you got eggs. And of course, homemade oranges. So, fresh oranges made by me. And you see, the funny thing is that I hardly make lunch. And if I'm gonna make lunch for somebody, it's because that person is really special. I consider the person a friend.
Wow,
so
thank you for this.
Omar is my friend. First and foremost, not just like a journalist and player thing, no, he's a friend. So,
thank you.
Yeah, wow. I invited a friend to my home and I made lunch for him, and I hope he likes it. So, Italian lunch, my girlfriend made all of this. I just did the microwaving part. But anyway, I hope Omar is gonna like it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now tell me, I've been here with you. I've noticed that you're very domesticated. You do a lot of homework. Mm-hmm. It's not too normal for footballers, you know. Mm-hmm. How did you come about this?
Okay, well, growing up, I was really lazy, you know, so I don't like to do the homeworks, chores at home and stuff. You know, but my mom, she made it obligatory. Yeah. So what was my job then was to clean the bathroom, the toilet. So my mom made sure I did that at least twice a week. I didn't like it, but I had to do it, because when my mom said I had to do something, there was no escaping for me. I had to do it. So, and then with the cooking part, I just liked it. Why I liked it? Because I always like to experiment. Yeah, so I like to, you know, take things and try to put them together and see how it comes.
Wow.
I don't care how it's gonna taste, if it's gonna taste bad or not, but I just think that, you know, cooking it gives me that chance to experiment. So when I'm on my free time and I don't know what to do, I just go in the kitchen and try to do something like,
wow.
Yeah. And
there's two fish in this dish.
Yeah. So, but these ones, were made by my girlfriend Omi.
Okay.
Awesome. Because when she's here, I don't do nothing.
Wow.
No.
You got a complete package, man.
Trust it. I mean, she taught me how to make this, so I think I could make this myself if I want to. she taught me how to make cake as well. So I can make cake. I can make pancakes.
Wow. I love pancakes. Unfortunately, I can't.
Yeah, I love pancakes
but
a lot.
My girlfriend does make them as well.
Yeah? Yeah. Pancakes are my favorite. I always eat pancakes. They're really nice. And then, Nigerian food.
What about asking you? They say you don't talk with the full mouth, but we
understand.
I'm doing an interview. What's your favorite Nigerian food?
I think my favorite Nigerian food is, no, I need to add two because rice and swallow is different, yeah? Mm-hmm. So, I think I like jollof rice a lot.
Jollof rice, the famous jollof rice.
But
jollof rice that have brought us fame.
With the situation that, you know, following my growing up, I can't pick jollof rice over beans and bread. Because beans and bread was like a savior, you know. It was like my everyday routine while I was playing in Nigeria. You know, every footballer had that. You know, it just keeps you going, it keeps you strong. You know, it keeps your belly full. So,
let me ask you. Sorry to cut you short. There are two types of beans. There's the wagon, which is the one for the boys in the hood. Yeah. I also ate that a lot. Is that what you're talking about?
Of course.
The wagon, and I give you bread.
Yeah. I mean, going to training, then after training, you just go and you eat that, and you know, like you're full for the day. And my mom really makes it good. My mom makes the jollof kind of beans. She makes it really, really, really good. And when we get back from training, we're eating that all the time.
Wow.
So jollof rice was more like a Christmas thing. So you just have to wait till Christmas before you got really good jollof rice and salad and stuff like that. So I think beans and bread would be my first, and then you got jollof rice, and I like soup as well. I like egusi soup. That's my favorite.
So beans and bread, jollof rice, and egusi soup.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. Have you ever tasted Ghana jollof? Ghana jollof.
How would I taste that? I didn't even know about Ghana.
Oh, really?
I think that
there's a serious debate going on social media about Ghana and Nigeria.
Yeah, because see, most of these debates about Ghana and Nigerian jollof, I never heard of Ghana jollof before. I mean, what was, like, all the while I've been living, I know about Nigerian jollof. So, like, jollof is, like, originally Nigerian. We got this name jollof and stuff, so I don't know about Ghana jollof, but okay. I mean, they might have their own jollof, but I pick Nigerian jollof above every other. Because it's really, really nice. So
thank you.
I think there's really no debate on this. So
that's another plus for Nigerian jollof. Nigerian jollof, once again, has defeated Ghana jollof in a contest. So Ghanaians, I'm sorry, just give up on this argument.
No, definitely, Nigerian jollof is the best. Like, really.
Oh, God. Time to go to work.
So how long do you need to drive to get to work?
40 minutes to drive to
train,
so. Well, it's not that far. It's really easy driving. Relax. Call mama. And drink drive, so it's nice. Alright, Oma. See you later.
Perfect.